put this in context with other big environmental fights we've seen over the last 10 to 20 years?
Well, there really hasn't been anything quite like it. We've talked to a bunch of sort of old guard environmentalists and other people who've said essentially that it's unmasked in spending for sure, but there have been a couple issues like the fight to stop drilling in the Arctic and the fight against acid rain that had been sort of on the same scale but lasted for years longer. So there's nothing really that comparable, I don't think.
Longer and arguably the substantive stakes were substantially higher, right?
Exactly,
that you're talking
right,
about acid rain like across the country. You're not talking about like one pipeline through the upper Midwest.
And there's been a lot of sort of grumbling behind the scenes about why there's been so much focus on this one project when there's a much bigger issue at play here, which is climate change.
Why is that? Because it's something concrete that people can focus on?
Yeah, I think in general it's a lot easier to oppose something specific, like a project that you can actually see being built, than to advocate for an idea, which is climate change.
What surprised you both most as you reported this story?
I think for me there are a lot of groups that have popped up almost solely to advocate on this issue. I mean, there's a couple groups in Nebraska in particular that if you were not on the ground there, you might not know, but and they, of course, some of them have ties to the oil industry or environmental groups.
But you wouldn't know it from the names, right?
Give us some
of the names.
I mean, there's this group called Nebraskans for Jobs and Energy Independence, for example, which has ties to the oil industry and the labor unions that are for the pipeline.
As opposed to the Nebraskans who are against jobs.
Right.
Exactly.
So there's a bunch of groups. And there's groups on the environmental side, too.
You knew it was expensive. You knew it was big. Right, but when you look through the lobbying disclosures at the groups that have sort of listed Keystone as an issue that they address, right? Like, who knew that the American Jewish Committee was registered to lobby on Keystone, right? Like, it is, presumably because it's part of like a larger energy package that's like more actually relevant to what the group cares about. But, if you were to add up like all the groups that are involved in any way in touching on Keystone in some conversation, their lobbying budgets are in like the hundreds of millions of dollars. And that's not all money that's being spent on Keystone, but it gives you some sense of just like the enormous resources that are involved. And you see in the political consulting community as well. I mean, if you go through the list of like lobbying firms, like, if you walk down Pennsylvania Avenue, basically any lobbying or law firm that you pass is going to have a Keystone contract in some way. And you have some of the biggest ad makers in the Democratic Party on both sides of the Keystone fight, right? Doing ads for TransCanada, doing ads for Tom Steyer. Everybody wins.
And that's another thing that's interesting is it's not, it doesn't break down perfectly along party lines, this issue, right? I mean, you have Democrats that are supportive of the project and Democrats who are opposed, and that then kind of continues on to the sort of consultative community.
I don't know anyone who thinks the Keystone is going to be like a huge voting issue in the midterms, right?
Right.
But what it is it's this great sort of club for Republicans to use against Democrats in coal states and Democrats in sort of oil states. Not because people care deeply about the pipeline, but because they don't trust the president on energy. And like Keystone, it's a lot easier just to say build the pipeline than it is to like explain why the president's energy policy is flawed. Then on the other side, you've got Democrats like Mary Landrieu in Louisiana or Mark Pryor in Arkansas who can create a little distance between themselves and the president by sort of ostentatiously getting out there and saying,
That's right.
I respect the president, but we got to build the darn pipeline.
Right.